If you are new to the channel, welcome. If you're not new, welcome back. If anybody's wondering why I sound so strange, I have been ill for the past week and a half, and it's gotten somewhat better, but typically I don't like to do anything while I am sick, because when I'm not sick, I'm an extremely cranky person, and so I try to avoid making videos while I'm like that, because I become incredibly rude. But I'm going to do my best to kind of keep that to a minimum, and today we're going to start with setting up the project that we are going to be building with Laravel and Breeze. You can see here, I have just a very basic Laravel installation. We don't have any authentication or anything on it yet. It is Laravel version 10.40, PHP, oh, we're up to 8.31. Wow. Okay, so that's where we are. But let's go ahead to the Laravel documentation so we can start installing this stuff. In the documentation, if you head over to the starter kits under the Getting Started tab, this is what we're going to be using to set this up. Now, a lot of people don't even really know what Breeze is or what the difference is between Breeze and Jetstream and things like that. And that's because when Laravel 8 came out, Laravel 8 came out with a whole just sort of host of different ways of using Laravel with some kind of a front end or just using Laravel on its own, like the installation that I have now. Now, something else people don't realize is that you don't even need these front ends or just sort of kits to use Laravel's authentication system because it's built within the code base of Laravel as it is. All these things do is bring a front end or bring some kind of scaffolding so that you can interact with it really easily. It's already set up for you to be able to use. You just need to have some sort of controller, some sort of routing system, some sort of front end in order to interact with it. And that's something that Breeze does provide. Now, before Laravel 8, we had to run a command called make auth, and this would scaffold out our Laravel projects for us. Now, that has been changed to what's called Laravel UI, and this will allow you to have a front end for Bootstrap, React, Vue, uses NPM, and it will further be maintained because there was a large uproar. How can you get rid of this? Some people didn't want to use Jetstream, which is why Breeze was brought into the picture, because they wanted to kind of replace this sort of thing here. But you can still use it and they will keep it active because, you know, there are people who still want to use stuff like this, and that's completely fine. But for our purposes, we're going to be using Breeze because I haven't really explored it with you guys, and our project is basically going to use the authentication system coming from Breeze. So let's go ahead down and take a look. This is a much shorter way of what I just explained. I think it's the fever, but basically it's giving us routes, controllers, views, etc. And it's just the scaffolding for it. And it's just a very basic starter kit. If you want something more robust, obviously you can use something else, but for our purposes, we are going to be using Breeze. If we go down a little bit, you can see this is the registration page. This is basically what we're getting. This is how you can tell it's Breeze because the logo is grayed out. The other starter kits like Jetstream will have the Jetstream logo here. So that's something to note as well. Now we can go ahead and require this in the project. This will start the installation process for us. So in the text editor, I'm going to open up a terminal. And since I'm using sail, I'm going to use that command there. And then I'm going to paste in the rest and let that install. So in the composer.json, you can see we have Laravel Breeze is installing right here. Now, something else too, you can use Laravel Breeze is to install scaffolding for an API, which I think is pretty cool. That didn't used to be, but it is an option. There's a lot of things going on with this installation. And now we can run the Breeze install command. They have different stacks here, which you can do Livewire with Volt class API with Alpine, Livewire functional API with, I wonder what the difference in these two is. I haven't tried it yet. You can also do React with Inertia. You can also do Vue with Inertia, and you can also do API only. And I believe that when you do these, let's say you wanted to do Vue with Inertia, this would have the basic authentication. So you wouldn't get things like things with the QR code and stuff like that, which Inertia, which pretty much sets us up with when we are using the Vue and Inertia. Or React with Inertia. And then there's also an API only, which you can use too. And that's pretty interesting too, because it creates controllers, routes, and everything for the API for you. Probably explore that at some point, but today I'm just going to use the blade with Alpine. Like dark mode, I'll say yes. And I'm doing that because I'm actually, I've added some other features to this project, including toggling dark mode and light mode. Testing framework, well, we're not going to be testing, so I'm just going to go with PHP unit. added some packages. That's for our node dependencies, our NPM stuff. We have a public build with the manifest JSON. These are our assets. And then it's been installed. So let's see what new things we have here. Go down to the package.json. And so now we have Tailwind. We have the Laravel Leap plugin. I think that was already there. So there's the Alpine.js is new. And I think the Tailwind stuff was installed just now as well. But at any rate, it has set us up with this Tailwind config. Yeah, so it's just installed the Tailwind stuff for us as well. If we go to our tests, you can see now we have some new tests in here. And these are just basic tests that it gets you started with, which is, you know, something if you were using Jetstream, that's what it would do as well. But if we take a look at the routes, you can see we have another file here called auth.php. And it has a registered controller, authenticated session controller. These are things for registering, logging in. There's forgot password, basically all of the basic authentication stuff that we're going to be using. This file is being called in the web.php. Go down to the bottom. You can see it's requiring that file. And it's there in our resources views. It has made some changes to our welcome view, our dashboard view. We have a profile folder now with some different things. We have some files for our layout components. Here are our auth pages. And it's kind of cool that they also give you the components here as well. And if we go to the JS folder, in the app.js, it has brought in Alpine for us so that we can use that as well. In our app.css, here's the Tailwind stuff. I think that's pretty much it for that, except for when we go up to the folder, we have an app layout, guest layout. These are our components. There's some things in our route service provider, which I'm assuming it brought in that. Okay, so I changed this to dashboard. I think it was home. Changed home to dashboard. And our models should be good. HTTP. Okay, so this is the validation for our profile. That's what's in this request folder in the auth. This is for logging in, email, password. And then in a controller folder, we have a profile controller here, which handles our profile. In the auth, we have our controllers that we just looked at in the web routes, the auth routes that we have. So let's go and see. Okay, so now we have the login and register. And that's new. That's new. You see how it's like a sticky bar up here? That's pretty cool. All right, so if we go to register, we now have this register page. Great. Now let's take a look. Make sure that we have everything. We need to migrate, and then it's already run that npm run install and run dev for us. So do sail npm run dev, just so that we can have that running in the background. Now, before we start actually putting in any code, I'm going to be leaving a download link in the description for you for all of the assets, all of the images, and the pages that we're going to be working on. This is what it's going to be once you unzip it. It's going to be a zipped file. It'll be a link to the Google Drive, where as you can see, I have all of our styling here. This way, you'll be able to download it and follow along with us. And then when I release the code after the end of the video, then you'll have the whole picture together, the assets, including the code that we'll be working on. We have everything here pretty much. Also, the images are going to be in their own file, their own folder. These are going to be all the images that we're using. And what I've done too is I've included an attributes text file, which is just attributions to all of the code. All of the images that we're getting are from either UNSPLASH or PIXABAY, which they're all free images to use. But I want you to have them if you want to follow along with us. Here are the links. Here are the creators. Here are the photographers of those images or the people who own the images. In addition to that, we have a no image icon. So when we're creating or something like that, we can just put that temporary image there until we change it. But that's pretty much everything that's going to be within this link. As I said, it's going to be in the description and as a pinned comment so that you'll have access to all of that. So the first one that I want to do is I want to take a look at this. And what I want to do is I'm just going to copy this. I'm going to copy it and we'll go to the welcome file. and get released out. Go ahead and check it and make sure we're getting the styling. We have our links and stuff, but we don't have any images or anything like that. First, let's go ahead and bring in the V resources and stuff for this page so we can make sure we're getting some tail. What we can do is just go over to the layouts in the app.play.php. We can go ahead and copy this script right here so that we can bring in V to this. Just make sure some of our styling is coming now. Let's go ahead and also work on getting these images in. In that file, you'll be able to download. There's a coderprise images folder, and then there's a pages folder that has our styling. So we're going to open up the images, and there's a folder here for defaults. And right now, I only want these two. I am going to come here. I'm going to go to my storage folder, app folder, public. I'm going to create another one called images. And then another one called defaults. Go ahead and drag these into that defaults folder. Now for here, instead of linking it from that other folder, I'm going to do curly brackets and parentheses storage. And so this is now coming from the storage folder, images, defaults. That's what we have right here. Now here we're going to do asset, because that's just the Laravel convention to be able to display our assets. We're not seeing our image yet. Let's open up the DevTools and see how we have a status of 404, the image is not found, but we know we have the image, right? Well, for me, what happened was when I installed this, this is our storage folder. And when you do it with inertia or something like that, what happens is there's a symlink that links to the public folder to be able to view this stuff. And we don't actually have that. Now I'm using sail, so mine's going to look a little bit different. I'm going to open up the terminal. And if you're using something like XAMPP, if this is the situation, you don't have any storage information in here. If you're using something like XAMPP, you can do sail artisan storage or PHP artisan storage link. Since I'm using sail, I'm going to do sail artisan storage link. Now this will create a symlink between our storage and the public folder. Again, as I said, I'm using sail, so I'm not going to get a folder here, but if you're using something like XAMPP in your local environment, you will. Let's check the browser now. I didn't change that one, but this is the image that we're going to be using for the welcome view. So we need that little car in here as well. If you're not sure where we're going from, I did a preview on this last week, so you can go and see kind of our layout for what we're doing. If you wanted to see it beforehand with some additional extras that I'm adding, you can go and take a look at that preview video. Now, something else too is if we didn't get our image at all, again, I'm using sail, so things are going to be a little bit different for me. But if you're using something like XAMPP and you did the storage link, your images, you should have, if you're using XAMPP, right, and you have a storage folder in here, you should be able to see these folders in there as well. Now, if all of that is true, and you're running your npm run dev, and your server is up and running, and you go back to your browser, and you don't see the image yet, but you see that little missing image icon that sometimes shows up, you might need to do something like that. So for XAMPP, this would be the server port. If you do that in here, you should be able to see your images. But again, as I'm using sail, that's not going to be really relevant. It's just something that I wanted to show you. Typically, when you don't see an image, 9 times out of 10, that's usually what's wrong. So let's go ahead and do the same thing for our car. See that? I'll pass it here. Storage. And then we'll remove this sort of a thing here. And we should be able to see this now. There it is. There's our car. Fantastic. Now, what we can also do is deal with these buttons. So we shouldn't have this if we're not logged in. And if we are logged in, then we shouldn't have this. So let's go do the logic for that as well. And that we can do here and have an if statement. And this is just typical Laravel. So if else plugin, head input stuff in here. also do an auth statement. So I'm going to put in else for these. These are just little Laravel directives so that if a user is authenticated, then they'll see this. If they're not authenticated, they'll see this, and then it's the end of the statement. Now, you might be used to seeing it something like if, I don't know, auth user, something like that. It's the same thing. This is just a much cleaner way of doing it. This is what's in the documentation, and this is how you'll see it most often. So if we're authenticated, then we'll be able to see this, the dashboard link. We can also change the route to that because we already have that dash. Dashboard route, and that's with the Breeze installation. If we're authenticated, we'll see this. If not, we will see this. Now we have a register and login. Now here we can say if route has register, you can see the register button. So this will be register. And there's an if, and then the next one is our login, which we can go ahead and add that as well. Check the browser and make sure that these are correct. Okay, good. So we have our two buttons. If you hover and you look down the bottom left down here, you'll see that that's pointing to register, and this is pointing to login. We can click it, we can register page, and then we go back, login, and we have our login page. All right, so let's go ahead and register. So we have a dashboard page. Now let's go back to that welcome view. And now we have the dashboard button here. I want to change this styling a little bit. I want to use a bit of a different font for this coderprise here. If you take a look here, I have a class called Welcome Font. And Laravel has been using the Fonts Bunny fonts instead of Google Fonts, which is pretty cool. It's an open source font system. It has everything that Google Fonts has, so it is pretty unique. But I do want to change the class, right? Let's go to our assets that we downloaded. And in here, we can go to that welcome view and see that class right here. And then I have the style up here. And all this is doing is it's just a class, and it's giving the font family and caveat brush is what I want to use, and the family itself is handwriting. I'm going to copy this. Should be good. Let's go and check it out. Our new font has been added. Fantastic. If you're enjoying the content, please go ahead and click that like button, as it really does help out the channel. Here's a video YouTube thanks you'll like, and here's a playlist to follow along. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.